Dear students, Assalamu alaikum. I am Muhammad Mukim, lecturer in English, Chanab College, Sharkot. First of all, I congratulate you upon getting promotion from part 1 to part 2 of your intermediate. May you keep getting promotions and making progress throughout your life. As you know that all of us in crisis, all of us in a testing time, all the people living in this world are disturbed and affected bitterly. All the activities performed by the people are bitterly affected, especially your education. In such a difficult time, Chanab College Sharkot has decided not to leave you on yourself. We have decided to keep you in touch with your studies. We have decided to help you avoid idleness and you utilize the best of your time. So we'll do our best and I hope that all of you would be fine, quite responding and responsible. As you know that I am a lecturer in English, so definitely I will teach you English. Before I teach you the first lesson, I think that it is necessary to discuss the paper pattern with you. Like first year's English, the English of second year is also consists on two parts, objective and subjective. Objective consists on three questions. The first question is about synonyms, that contains 10 marks. Second, correction, that contains 5 marks. Third, preposition, it contains also 5 marks. So the total marks of objective are 20. The second part of this paper is subjective. It also contains 5 questions. So first questions deal with short questions that contain 40 marks. Second, essay, it contains 15 marks. Third, idioms, it contains 10 marks. Fourth, translation, it contains 15 marks. The total marks are 80. In this way, the paper of 100 marks is complete. If you take my opinion, the English of second year is easier and shorter than that of first year. When we deal with the question of translation from Urdu to English, it is quite easy. It depends upon only two things, that skills of translating from Urdu to English, and second, a lot of practice. If you do the both things, in the end of the year, you are able to translate any paragraph, even that is unseen, that no matter would be for you. You would have to learn 300 to 400 idioms in order to attempt the question of idiom. Similarly, you will have to learn 15 to 20 essays to attempt the paper of essay, question of essay writing. Whereas the matter of short question is concerned, short question and synonyms will be done during the reading of the lessons. So it is quite easy and it is the main purpose of the reading of the lesson. One thing is very important to discuss with you, that in second year's English there is no translation from English to Urdu as you would have to do in your first years. So then the question is that why we do the reading? That is just because we have to solve our questions and we have to learn our synonyms, and thirdly we have to learn the skills of reading and understanding the comprehension as well. Dear students, this is the first lesson entitled as The Dying Sun. The dying sun means the sun that has risen once and now going towards its end, going towards setting in. But it is not the sun which we see really coming from the east and going towards west. Perhaps it is the sun of our life, or the sun of the life of everything lying around us, are the sun of the life of the earth or the universe where we are living. This lesson has been written by Sir James Jeans. He is a great man. He is a British professor of physics and mathematics. He is an adept in physics. He was born in 1877 and died in 1946. He wrote a lot of books which a student, if has a curiosity, must go through, because curiosity is a hallmark of a student. Without having kirasti, a student is just like a deer standing around a water pool, having no desire to drink water. He wrote many books. Out of them, the universe around us. Secondly, the mysterious universe, the new background of science, and the last one is physics and philosophy are more interesting and very important. In the lesson, The Dying Sun, we mainly learn these four things. The first, existence of the earth. Second, existence of life on the earth. Third, our state of fear. And fourth, physical conditions of life and other stars. But today we'll deal with only the first one, that is existence of the earth. First thing is to be kept in mind that this is not a scientific research. It is just an opinion of the writer that this perhaps in this way our earth came into existence and then life began over it. So this is just his, these are just his views. The writer says that the planets and our earth, which is so short that thousands and millions of us can be packed in a star, and even then there is an empty place in the star. So it came into existence perhaps 2000 million years ago, when a star which was moving around the sun came closer to the sun, and it raised huge tides on the surface of the sun. As it came nearer the sun, it raised huge the tides on the surface of the sun assumed the shape of a huge mountain. It was so huge mountain that we cannot even imagine. So this mountain was torn into part due to the power of attraction, and then these pieces of that mountain started moving around the sun. So these pieces which scatter around the sun are called planets, and our earth is one of them, having suitable physical conditions on it. The assumption made by James Hind can be understood through this model. As this is a star, it comes closer to the sun, and because of its power of attraction, there are the waves and tides on the surface of the sun. So as it comes closer, so these waves get higher and higher, and they make a fountain. Just because of the power of attraction, this the mountain of waves start into pieces, and these pieces swell around the sun and then make a planetary system out of which our earth is a part.